So I just got my toes done and my hands. I just got a manicure and a pedicure, but not acrylic, just regular. I'm not gonna do acrylic nails anymore because they destroy your fingernails. Then when you get the acrylic off, it's just your nails are all ripped up underneath. So my boss, it was for, I guess it was Secretary's Day a few weeks ago or something. And he gave all the secretaries in the office manicures and, you know, free manicure pedicure at the beauty salon. So, but I don't have any shoes to wear. I'm going to wave the lights about. I don't have any shoes that I can wear that won't mess up my nails, so. Okay, I'm going to turn this on later when something more exciting happens. I want to try that place. That's called Komodo. It's a restaurant. So look at that. It's got like a nest. I don't know what it is, but that's a restaurant. Komodo, it's called. Okay, now from here, I put my regular shoes on now. I hope my nails are dry enough. I've been walking around for like 20 minutes or so. I hope that's enough. But what I'm going to do is, from here, I'm going to go to, I'm going to take the train, see if I can get the train up there. I'm going to go to the mall. At the end of the line, there's a shopping mall. Because I have a $10 gift certificate for Macy's. Shoot, I ran out of money on my card. I have to add some money on there. So let's see, I'm gonna load my card. I gotta tap my card down there. It's in my purse here. Make a selection. I'm gonna add cash value. I guess I'll put 20 on there. I take it enough. I gotta stick my card in. Right here. I'm not wearing my glasses, so I can't really see what I'm doing, but since I already know how to do it, enter my zip code. Enter. It's authorizing. Okay, now I gotta tap the card. Do I want a receipt? No, I do not. Okay, now I have money on my card. See, it's this green card here. It detects it through the and it opens the door and I can go in. And it deducts it as I go. Oh, shoot. I'm gonna climb up the stairs. Look at that. Oh, bummer. Look at that. Ugh. I could take the elevator, but I hate the elevator. It's so gross. Let me... You can't even see my toes going up the stairs here. All right. It's actually good exercise to go up the stairs, so... I'm chewing gum by coincidence. Okay, when the train comes, I'll just film it coming. Oh, I think I hear it. JC Penney, which I actually shop at JC Penney a lot. They've got excellent career wear and it's not that expensive. Okay, so I don't see anything really great. You know, there's a lot of stuff on sale, good pricing, but nothing You know, you have some of these swimsuits. I like to shop for plus size and put it on my Poshmark shop. Because I'm good at dressing large women. Because I was one once. So I know the kind of basics that look good on them. And then, of course, depending if you're top heavy or bottom heavy. So you got a lot of winter stuff. Like, look at that Christmas stuff. It's really cheap now. So if you're willing to buy it now and hold off until next winter, till next Christmas, you know, that's really pretty, that one. Size 4. And that one's only $20.97, down from $72. So it's, you know, that's something I actually would wear to a Christmas, maybe a Christmas party if I'm not feeling too sexy. You know, it's a little bit modest, but yeah, nothing yet that's really thrilled me that I'd say, whoa, you know, because the winter stuff, who's in the mood to buy winter stuff right now? Not many people. But anyway, I better get to Macy's. I can't afford to waste time in here. Yeah, but I'm pretty good. I'm pretty good about not just splurging and buying mindlessly. When I buy stuff, I'm very that's kind of nice. Like for a chilly spring morning. I am good about controlling my spending. I'm proud to say. That's like one of the few things I do well. Is not spend, maybe I'm a little bit of a stingy. Maybe I'm a little to the other extreme, but anyway, it's worked for me in life. This Claiborne, I don't need another pair of jeans, but don't tell me that's $1.97. That can't be right. It says reduced to $1.97, but that cannot be right. Does that say $1.97? That cannot be right. If that's $1.97, I might get it just because. I mean, I'll try them on for $1.97, please. I think I even have that in change in my purse. I'm gonna try these on. I mean, for $1.97, it's worth trying on. Oh, I love these kind of pockets. But these are too big for me. Okay. Anyway. Okay, I gotta get to Macy's. I'll try these on, then I'm gonna go to Macy's. I think I know why they're $1.97, because they've got that something spilled on there, and they're a little bit like Clorox or something spilled on them. Or maybe that's what they're supposed to look like. Maybe that's what they're supposed to look like. I don't know. I'll try them on, though, because I could always just dye that. Okay, good news, bad news. The good news is when I buy in the junior section, like here, see, the bottoms are not, see, the length is perfect. Usually when I buy in the adult jeans, they're too long. They're always too long. So that's the good news. The bad news, it makes my butt look really flat. I'm too embarrassed to turn to the side. You know, because they've got some spandex in them, so I'm not really happy about how they fit. But they're so comfortable. They're spandex. It's like leggings. But see, my butt is really flat. It's not a firm young one. It's, you know, an old butt. So I'm not gonna get them. So these are the $1.97 jeans. You know, they're a little bit, oops. Didn't mean to show that much. They're a little, you know, I'm more of a modest type for dressing, so. But, you know, again, no butt. I really don't know what to do about my. I think the only solution is get an implant. Get two of them. In the back, that's about all I can do. And, you know, they're just straight to the ground, so I already don't have any curves. And they just go straight down. The other ones made me look a little curvier, so. You know, just depending on which angle you see me in. So I'm not getting either one. Even though these are only $1.97, I'm not getting them. Actually, I already know I'm not going to get the ones that were tighter. I'm not going to get those because they don't look awesome on me. They might fit, but they don't look awesome. And they're $27.95 before tax. So that's already more than, I mean, I wasn't even, I don't need jeans, first of all. So why am I going to spend almost $30 after tax? More than $30 after tax. Now the $1.97 ones, I'll think about those. Because, you know, for $2, even though they don't look that great on me, you know, maybe I could do something with them, you know, on a day I'm not feeling too fancy. But I really don't need jeans. Even for, you know, even for $1.97, maybe someone else could take advantage of those jeans better than me. And I'm not even sure they're $1.97. I think they're $1.97. Because that's what it looked like. It said on the, what do you call it, price tag. And it could be because they're so plain and boring that nobody wanted them. So they just marked them down to that ridiculously low price. So that someone would buy it like me, like an impulse buyer, for $2. If you sew, you could even get them and make something out of them. You know, cut them up for patchwork quilt or, you know, at that point. But I don't really have any use for them. So I'm going to go down to Macy's. This is one of my favorite malls. There are so many malls here now. But this is just a multi-purpose mall. Well, but it's just the right size. It's not too big. It's not too small. Some of those malls, like the outlet malls up in Fort Lauderdale, oh my gosh, it's huge. Sawgrass Mills is too big. And you just get so drained. And the prices aren't even that much cheaper than you can find here. You know, on a good day, on a sale day. Winter clothes, you can imagine, are really cheap right now. But I didn't see anything that's even worth buying now and holding off till next winter. So. Okay, I'll turn it on when I get to Macy's. Well, here's Macy's. Oh, there's Macy's right there. That's where I'm going to use my... Except I want to go to the housewares. This is the clothing. So Macy's housewares, I think, is through the clothing store on the other side of the mall. Because Macy's takes up two big parts of the mall. So when I get there... Or maybe I could just film going through Macy's if you feel like going through Macy's. I love skylights. It keeps the place naturally lit. That's important. It makes the mall nicer. You want to stay here longer and then you shop longer. So it's all planned that way. And it smells so good, all the perfume. I guess we're near the perfume counter and the spray samples. Unwilling passersby. Remember they used to, well, I don't know, some of you are young, so you might not remember, but when they first started that, standing at the perfume counter trying to offer you perfume, they used to just spray it on you without your permission. And I guess that, you know, people would complain. Now they ask your permission or they spray it on a little paper card. Because imagine if they sprayed you with perfume. Back in those days, they would spray you with perfume. And then what if that perfume made you sick and you had to shop the rest of the day? But it really smells nice. If I weren't standing here all day. I think if I had to work here all day in the perfume section, I'd get sick. But yeah, the shopping mall is fun. Especially the makeup section. You can try makeup on. I love that. I try not to film anybody like head on. So anyway, I'm not going to get distracted. I want to go straight to housewares and find a nice linen napkin. See, that's what I came for. And that's the difference between men and women in general. The way of shopping, I've heard that men know what they want. They try to find it as quick as they can, get it, and leave. That's how men shop. And women, oh, I think I'll get a linen napkin, but... Oh, by the way, why don't I have a look at some of these blue jeans? And then, oh, and look at my, when I try these on. It's like we mosey on over to where we're going, and it could take us 2 or 3 hours because we keep stopping and wanting to, you know, look at stuff. So that's definitely me. I shop like a woman, for sure. And I might not even end up buying a thing. I probably won't. I probably will end up just buying if I find a decent-looking linen or cotton napkin, you know, a fancy one. That's probably all I'll buy today. But I want to try things on and compare, and then I might have something in my head and come back. And all that was completely unintended. But sometimes you discover things that way. I discovered these great vests that I sold. I sold all of them. They were like $9.97, $10, fringe vests. I sold all of them. I bought five. I kept one for myself, and all the other four sold on Poshmark, my Poshmark shop. You know, I'm not even embarrassed about filming and talking like I used to be. I mean, so many people do it now, it's not as embarrassing as it used to be. And for all they know, I'm talking on a fancy big cell phone or something. I'm not, I'm using my video camera. So actually, if I were using my phone, it would be less obvious. But if someone were to look at me, it would be pretty obvious that I'm filming. But I'm not that embarrassed about it. See, now there's Macy's Children's Wear. Right there is where I'm going. Macy's. Let me see if I can move in. I'm going right there. Home and furniture. I gotta not get distracted though, because I really want to get home. I'm hungry. I'm sorry. I just wanted to show you this. That is so adorable. I would wear that. I would definitely buy that. It's sort of like a big bathing suit. It's so cute. I guess it's shorts, but it's sort of a bathing suit. Oh, that's so cute, but it's probably expensive and I can't afford it right now. Look at the Zara counter. I mean, look at the Zara window. That's mixing and matching colors in an interesting way. Okay, guys, so I have been here for at least 20 minutes. I cannot find anything that's worth it that's $10. I mean, there are things that are $10, but it's not something that we need. I can't find a beautiful napkin, like in the fancy section, like the you know, wedding registry section. No beautiful, just a plain white napkin. That's all I want. But linen, you know, the fancy stuff. And I thought, okay, well, I can't find one. I'll get a dish towel, because we do need it. Dish towel. A dish towel couldn't cost more than $10, you'd figure, right? So they have these Martha Stewart dish towels for three for $23. So that's not going to help me any. And that's all they have, just Martha Stewart dish towels. And three for $23 before tax. So that's completely useless to me, because I need a $10 item, because I'm not going to take out of my pocket. So I don't know what I can get. Oh, look at that copper. Copper bowls are good for making meringue. I went to cooking school for a while. One of my many unfinished careers. And I remember them telling us that copper was good for making meringue. For beating the eggs, something about the copper made the eggs fluffier. I don't remember even why. But see, I mean, these were, you know, I wouldn't have minded getting a dish towel. A dish towel, not three, for $24.99. It's crazy. I mean, it's not that expensive, but I just want a $10 item. So there was some really pretty stuff downstairs. Maybe I should ask. I didn't ask if they had linen napkins. I just looked and I didn't find them. Like table settings, you know, the napkin. So I guess I'll go back downstairs and just ask. She's got some cute stuff. She made popsicles in the summertime. How about party napkins? How much are these? $11.99. And these are, I mean, it's a little bit frustrating. What about this? That's a plate. It's kind of, that's $18, so that's not good. I mean, probably I'll have to end up spending a little more and then just request that they return it to me. How much is this? $16.95, because there are people at work that drink tea. But tea for, oh, maybe it's on sale though. It says $16.95. But there's a special sale going on, but that doesn't look like it's on sale. Finest quality black, green, white, and herbal teas. And right now we have a lot of tea at work. Tea, we have coffee at work. All right, I'll figure something out. I could look at some of these towels, but they're, you know, like maybe a hand towel. Maybe a hand towel, actually. That might be useful. I mean, a very small hand towel for people, like they wash their hands at work in our kitchen and they use the paper towels and it gets wasted. And that's not even, let's see, the smallest one. Let's see if I can see the price. These are really fluffy. It's nice. Tumbler, toothbrush, no, that's... these are all big. Oh, the hand towel is $8.80. Okay. And the washcloth is $5.60. So maybe I could get a hand towel for $8.80. That's, let's try that. Look, I found the clearance section. It was in hiding. And they've got all this stuff. I think I'll be able to find something here. There's gotta be something I can find for $10. Okay, so it was a little bit embarrassing. I'll tell you what just happened. I went through that clearance section, and I found two napkins, you know, two linen, not, you know, see, 100% cotton. They need ironing for sure. But, you know, that's just exactly what I was looking for. I was actually looking for something a little fancier, but there were some polyester cotton blends that were a little tacky, you know, the little shiny ones, and they don't even work. When you go to a fancy dinner and you have those kind of napkins, you try to wipe your mouth and they're not absorbent. But these are 100% cotton, and the price is $9.53, so that was under $10. And then I said, okay, with tax it's gonna go over a few cents, but so it went over by, like, after $10 it was like $10.20 something. I don't have the receipts in the bags anymore, but so I was 6 cents short. I fished through my purse and I had 14 cents. And I was so embarrassed because I was like, oh, I'm sorry, could you please lend me to the cashier? He looked like he was 20 or something. So I had to ask him to loan me the money, but he was nice. I mean, he could have been mean. I just felt kind of goofy. I said, what do I do? It was exactly what I wanted. But, so he loaned me the 6 cents. He probably took it out of his own pocket. I mean, I know it's not a lot of money, but I can see the right asking. Anyway, but I want to get home. I'm so hungry. I was getting ready to buy candy and I stopped myself because I said, I'm just going to go home and eat something healthy. I haven't eaten since breakfast. I'm usually home by about 4. So then I have my dinner when I get home. But today, since I took this, you know, I went and I got my nails and my feet nails, my manicure, pedicure. And then I came over here, so I don't even know what time it is, but it's many hours later than I usually eat. And so, yeah, I was just getting ready to go to get some candy. There's a CVS here. And I stopped myself. I said no, which was really hard for me because I'm just so desperately wanting candy. Like, even my mouth is watering thinking of what I've left behind. But, all right, I'm just going to turn this off so I can walk really fast. Look at those cute things. So cute. That one's really adorable. This one shoulder thing up. I guess that's in style again. And then the gypsy. All right, I'm so hungry. What am I doing? You see? But there's such cute things. All right. And I just look and I don't ever buy anything. Or, you know, wait till it's on sale and I buy it. Okay, I got it. I turn this off and I'm just going to walk really fast. Oh my gosh, I just was about to turn around and get the candy. All right, I'm going to be really, I'll tell you what happened when I get home. All right, getting ready to get on the train home. Look at that pretty view from the metro rail. I think I see some ducks. Yeah, there's some ducks. It's hard to keep the camera still when you... Alright guys, so I finally was able to find what I was looking for at Macy's yesterday. See, I found two of these nice, really good quality linen napkins. But notice, I found this one I've already wet. You know, they're very wrinkled. So, you know, they've been folded up for a while. So I wet this one. I'm going to do the same to the other one. But they're so white, I don't want them to touch anything. Get them dirty. Anyway, so let's see. Oh, this is hard because I plugged it in and the plug is in the way. Let's see, I'm creating steam. I should have gotten the ironing board. See, I try to do ASMR and then something always happens, like a dog decides to drink water. So, here we go. So it dries really quickly because it's on super hot. Linen can be on the hottest setting, because cotton takes a very high heat to burn. But of course, you don't want to just leave the iron sitting on there. I might have to move this up a bit. So I only am able to get half of it ironed because the electrical cord is not long enough. So what I'm going to do is move it up closer now. Here, so I can get the bottom. And now this will look nice, and I'll use it to decorate our client's conference room where my bosses meet with clients who stop in. And in that room we have coffee and little cookies and tea. And we have to keep it looking nice. So I just thought, since we had this $10 gift certificate, which belongs to the office, I thought we could just get some nice linen napkins, but I was having so much trouble finding them yesterday, as you recall. And then last minute, see how it pays to go on a side tangent? Because I ended up finding them where you wouldn't have expected to find them. The guy had told me they would be downstairs in the wedding registry. And I ended up finding them upstairs in the very back in a clearance section. So that's why sometimes having a definite idea of where you're going and what you're going to do isn't always beneficial. Just for your reference. I mean, it helps to have a general idea. I mean, I did have decided that I was pretty sure. I was actually thinking I might end up getting something else because, you know, since I wasn't finding what I was looking for, but as it turns out, I ended up finding exactly what I was looking for. So pretty. Sometimes it's so hard to find something simple like this. I was just looking for a piece of linen fabric, you know, like this, but neatly, you know, the seams neatly done. And so this napkin's done. Let's have a look at it. Actually, like I, the thing with linen, you iron one part and then you barely touch it and the other part gets wrinkled, you know, and it's still slightly damp. So I was thinking I would hang it up so it finished drying. Maybe put it in the sun because I want it to be super crisp. Stand up. It's hard to be down there ironing from the floor. It's easier to be taller than what you're ironing. All right. Okay, it's never going to be perfect because linen always has a little bit of wrinkle in it, but at least they're freshly wrinkled. When it's been folded up for a long time, those wrinkles look really ugly. Now it has some wrinkle in it, but it's a different kind of wrinkle. I'm still going to try to make it a little bit better, but okay, guys. Talk soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.